Drag Race star Courtney Act is set to appear in Neighbours today with a special role. It's all about celebrating this year's Pride. Courtney Act joins me now. Oh, wow, you look amazing. I'm loving the whole look.
Is it safe to take it off?
Yes, it is.
It hasn't gone digital yet.
It's fine. There you go. Oh, don't you look gorgeous this morning? And I love that you're in Neighbours. How did that all come about?
Oh, my gosh. I love that I'm in Neighbours too. So last year, Neighbours went to the Sydney Gay and Lesbian Mardi Gras. Lassiter's actually had a pride float, and I had a itty-bitty cameo in that. And the executive producer, Jason, was down on set, and I sort of jokingly, thinking that the idea was ridiculous, was like, oh, my God, I should totally come and perform at Lassiter's. And he was like, that's a good idea. And then it happened.
And then it happened, which is terrific. I mean, because when you were little and growing up, you watched the show and you wanted to be in it. And here you are.
Yeah. Well, the funny thing is that Neighbours was like a rite of passage for any Australian in the entertainment industry. Like, the goal was to get on Neighbours so that you could go to the UK and be known there and then release pop music. I mean, I kind of did it backwards a little bit, but that's okay.
But that's all right. It doesn't matter. You're right, because the whole time, I mean, I remember, you know, people love it here in the UK, and it's on Channel 5 now, but people absolutely love it. And it gave us a glimpse into sort of what we thought was Australian life, something that we aspired to.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, me too. Growing up in the suburbs of Brisbane, I got to see what all the people down in Melbourne were doing. It was very exciting.
Exactly. Now, look, this is all about Pride in Lassiter's. I'm loving that because, of course, it is Global Pride Month, but everything is on hold. We're doing a lot of things remotely like this. You know, we're doing a lot of things online, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny because Prides have been cancelled for the most part in real life, but one of the places you can watch people celebrating Pride, touching each other and wandering around and breathing on each other and hugging, is on Neighbours at Lassiter's.
Yeah, exactly, because it was all done beforehand, wasn't it? It was all done before all of this happened. How are you dealing with all of this, love? How's it going?
It's been good. I was in Los Angeles for the first 3 months of quarantine. I got there on the first day of lockdown, and you know, I've actually been lucky in many ways, but I've been working on a book, and this was the time that I was meant to write it. So I've actually had something to totally focus on, and I've had no fear of missing out from any of my friends because no one's been doing anything. But then a few weeks ago when the protests started happening in the US in response to George Floyd's death, it was a really powerful time to be there marching in the streets and protesting. But then I had to come back to my little home in London because I had a bunch of work at the end of the month, which probably won't happen in real life, still, it turns out. But at least my Wi-Fi connection is a little bit more spontaneous talking to you here.
Yes, it's very good, which is what we need right now. It's never been more important. And we have really adopted you, I guess, since you won Celebrity Big Brother. You know, you're a sort of adopted Brit, really. And is this home now, or do you find that you're just kind of global? You're everywhere.
I mean, I'm a bit everywhere. Always the one. I spent the summer, Australian summer, in Sydney, and then I was in LA for 3 months. But this is my actual home, where all of my belongings are. So it's just nice to be back home in my bed. I've got those coloured light bulbs that you can talk to, and each morning I wake up and I say, "Alexa, rainbow." And she turns on the lights, rainbow in the house, and it makes me happy.
That.
I love being here in the UK.
That's a good idea. I like that. And it's nice to have somebody to talk to as well. And she doesn't answer back.
No, not
sometimes
too bad.
Not. Now, look, you were all set to go on this massive mega tour, which was an extravaganza. It's still going to be happening, though, just being like the Oscars, just being postponed for a little while.
Exactly. My tour Fluid for my new live show, which I launched at the Sydney Mardi Gras this year, which was sold out and got amazing reviews, is going to be touring all around the UK and Europe in April 2021. And we're announcing it today here first. And then there's going to be a pre-sale on Friday, and then tickets go on sale on Monday. And I'm super excited because this is the first time that I've written all of the music that I'm performing live with a band in the show. So it's really special. It's fun, but it's also got some real heart to it.
Exactly, and that's what you need. It's got to come from your heart. And that's the thing about you. You are the whole package, though, because, you know, you write your own stuff. You look absolutely beautiful. Of course you do. You can act, you can sing, you can dance. You can do all of these things. You're an all-round entertainer. And they're few and far between.
Well, I just love it. I grew up going to, it's called the Fame Agency, it's a singing and dancing and acting school that I'd go to after school. And it was less about the dancing and more about the performance and putting on a show. And I just learned from a young age, doing pantomimes actually in Australia, like Cinderella. I was a mouse in Cinderella. And I've just always loved performing and being on stage. And so this show that I'm doing is just a thrill. And because I've written all the music myself, it suits my voice a lot better. My best friend Vanity sometimes critiques some of my high notes. She describes them as sounding like a hungry alley cat. And so she said that there is no hungry alley cat in this show, which she really appreciates. Oh, and actually, the music in the show, some of it I'm releasing next week as a little teaser. There's three songs that will be coming out, which is very exciting.
Oh, fantastic. And I know we saw you, gosh, it feels like such a long time ago now, in another life, really, when you did that sort of one-woman show, and it was a big extravaganza, a big Christmas extravaganza.
Oh, yes.
And I just see you doing things like that, you know, that sort of idea, these big, big, big productions, because we don't really have many people that do that at the moment.
I know, and I just think it's the time to call that back. There's a real callback. Like, you know, we've got the old game shows coming back. I think the variety specials need to come back. So ITV bosses, if you're listening, by all means, throw me a bone.
Absolutely. Hire Courtney. That's what we need.
Yes.
You're right. You're absolutely right. It's that sort of thing that I was talking about this yesterday, about the fact that we're listening to music at a time when we felt happiest and safest. It's like a little sort of cosy blanket, you know, the music we're listening to, the movies that we're watching. And I think you're right. I think there is absolutely, let's bring back variety, bring back the big Saturday night show. I mean, I know Ant and Dec do takeaway and that sort of thing, but a big, you know, with lots of different acts, I think it would work really well.
Yeah, well, it's funny because in quarantine, you know, you tend to, like you said, listen to music or do sorts of find activities to amuse yourself. And I have been watching old YouTube videos of like variety specials in the UK, and the UK just does them so well. And so when I got to do that Christmas special, it was amazing. And I'd certainly love to do more of that because I just love working with a live audience. That might be a while away, but I just love the performance side of it.
Well, look, it has been a joy. It always is. And I love the fact that you can put that look together in what, 30 seconds?
Well, I think it took a few hours. You can watch my Instagram story. The hot water's out at my house.
So I know.
Wasn't able to shower this morning, but I did just shave with a pot of hot water just for you, Lorraine. I didn't
Thank
want any
you.
Well,
you
look, 5 a.m. shadow.
You look really gorgeous, and it's always a joy to see you. And, of course, we'll see you in Neighbours today, 1:45
yes.
and 5:30 on
yes.
Channel 5. A joy.
All this week.
Fantastic. Thank you, my love.
Lots of love.
Great
Happy
to see
Pride.
You. Thank you.